In this video, we're gonna continue our exploration of bringing our stills to life using Photoshop and After Effects. In part one, we looked at Photoshop and using some of the Gen AI features, not to mention great object selection tools to cut out our photo. In part two, we brought that into After Effects and separated the layers and added some camera animation, not to mention animation of the layers using the puppet tool. Last but not least, we're gonna use Boris Effects' Continuum and Sapphire for the final touches to really bring our photo to life, and then use BCC+UpRes to make the animation even larger. Let's get started. In part two, we finished with the puppet pin tool where we added a bit of motion to the Johnny Cash layer. And now what we wanna do is apply the overall color look preset that we saved from optics and use film stocks inside of Continuum to access it. What I'm gonna do is go to the layer menu and we're gonna add a new adjustment layer here. It will exist at the top of our composition and I'll just call this effects. And here in my effects and presets, I'm gonna do a search for film stocks. And we should see under the BCC film style category, this effect. So I'm gonna apply it to the clip. And nothing's going to change about our image just yet, but we're going to head over to the effects editor from effect controls. Here are all of these presets that you have available. And I just so happen to have saved the preset that we created in optics under custom and have this available now within Continuum. So that was this Fuji film look. And to show you where this is saved, I'm just going to right click this and choose open custom preset location. Here's my Continuum folder with all of the presets, including film stocks, where you'll see I've just basically dragged and dropped that XML that was saved within optics to here. And you could do the same on your system to transfer that data from optics over to Continuum. And the same thing with S effects, which are Sapphire effects. Simply save those as presets and then have Sapphire see them by dragging it into your custom preset location within Sapphire. Now that this film look is set up, I'm just gonna make one subtle change, which is go to the bottom of the parameters here, where I increase the size of grain for demonstration purposes. I'm just gonna bring that down to a value of 1, and now apply that to the image. I'll close out the properties for film stocks within effect controls, and let's continue adding some effects to our image. Another effect that I like to use when it comes to photo treatments is light leaks. And I'll apply this from the BCC+Light Leaks category, but if you have Sapphire, Sapphire has light leaks as well that you can take advantage of. Right away, we can see this lovely moving, mutating light across our image. And I'll just go into the effects editor to show you that there are several presets that you can pick from, depending on the type of look that you like. I like these purple blobs, but we will note that they are very intense in terms of their glow. And they happen to be moving very quickly. I'll apply it to my composition and we'll just do a few things here. One is that if you head over to your stylized section, there is something called a texture mutation rate, which is currently set to 92. I'm gonna bring this or cut this close to half. I'll make that 50. And if I scrub the timeline, we should see that these light leaks are moving a little bit less. Another thing that I'll also bring down is the opacity of the light leaks here, and also choose to mix this into the original. So the light leaks are a lot more subtle overall on our image. The best part about BCC+Light Leaks are there are several preset starting places, and then you can tweak those however you like to add these overlay elements onto your footage. I'll now close out BCC+Light Leaks. And next up, I want to actually add some moving particles to the scene as well, but I'll make sure that it's behind all of our subjects and just floating around in the background. One way to do that is to select the background layer, and let's just go layer, new adjustment layer, so it's added there. I'm gonna press the return key and call this dust in this case, and I'll do a search inside my effects and presets for S dust. I'll apply it, and just so that we can focus on it, I'm just gonna show the background and the dust. You should be able to see these moving particles here in the scene. If you can't quite do this underneath the dust properties in effect controls, I'll just increase the scale. So you can see well, now not moving dust, but this is moving bokeh throughout your scene. Just like in Continuum, with Sapphire plugins, we can choose to load a preset. And for the photo that we're currently using, I'm looking for something a bit slow. And I'll see several presets have been named Extra Slow Drift in this case, and also telling me the direction that it's moving in, not to mention that it's auto-animated with a little bit of flicker. I'll load that here. We'll see that it changes automatically. And let me just bring down the quality of the preview to half so we can see this animation a little bit better. I find the dust to be too big and too much in this case. So I'll just take the preset, bring down the number to 2000 in this case of the amount of dust, and also bring down the size to 70. So this is a lot more subtle. I'll unsolo the two layers so we can see dust in relation to the subjects in this case. And this is just great. Now it's time to add some effects that we're going to animate over time in order to have this transition in this photograph. Okay, first off, we want to add a texture to our photograph that then essentially disappears when the camera animation starts over the period of 2 seconds. In order to accomplish this, under my effects and presets, this time I'm going to just do a search for texture. I should be able to find under the BCC Textures category, BCC Texture. I'll just add this to my effects adjustment layer, and we can see its automatic impact on the photo. I'm going to twirl up the properties for both film stocks and light leaks so we can focus on this. In the effects editor, I'll see several different textures mimicking different paper stocks that we can choose from. And once we find one we like, let's apply it to the image, and we'll start off with this texture. But in order to have it minimized as the animation continues, I'll add a keyframe to the amount value at the beginning of my composition. And then at around 3 seconds, let's have the amount of this texture be pretty much close to zero. I'll leave it at 10%. So that animates in over time. And it's at the same time that that texture animates out that we want to have the Johnny Cash photo color layer come in. With the Johnny color layer selected, I'll press T for opacity. I'll add a keyframe. Let's make that zero. Let's move to 3 seconds. Set the value to 100. I'll make sure it's 0% opacity. And I can see now that the Johnny Cash color photo comes in over time. There's just one problem, which is the color layer doesn't have the puppet tool applied. That's easily fixable. Where I'll select the Johnny layer, which we applied the puppet tool to, press E for effect, select puppet, and press Command C, and then just go to the beginning of the timeline and just paste that puppet layer. So now we've got the same head movement on color as we did on the black and white layer. Last but not least, we want to just add one element, which is a photography flash to give this a transition intro along with the texture. I'll just add another adjustment layer to this, and I'll call this flicker. Let's go to effects and presets and type in light flicker, which we'll find in the BCC style category. I'll double click it to apply it to the adjustment layer. And since I want this flicker to only be about a second, I'll move my current time indicator to that place and then just use option right square bracket to trim the flicker adjustment to end on this frame. Let's go into the effects editor. Just so happens to be a couple flicker presets that we can use exactly for this situation. And in this case, I'm going to choose paparazzi photo flash. We'll apply it. And as I scrub the time indicator, you can see these bright and dark flashes mimicking that photo flash. One thing we could do is, of course, increase that so it blows it out altogether. I'll set it to be a value of 70. And we can also try to play around with which frame the flash actually hits. And to do that, we just want to scrub on the random seed value here. So I'm just using this to try to get a photo flash right at the beginning of my timeline. And now, over a second, I have these bright as well as dark flashes that take place. And if I didn't want the dark, I could just choose bright only from the flicker type. We have the photo flashes, the texture, as well as the Johnny Cash color animate in. Now, last but not least, we know that this photo isn't Ultra HD, which is what we want to export to. So for this, I'm going to use BCC+UpRes. Head to my project panel, where I'm going to select the composition where I did all of my animation, and drag it into a new composition. in this new composition, I'm going to go to my composition settings. And under custom, I'm going to choose a UHD 23976 preset from the list. We can see that the comp layer gets a lot smaller, but that's okay. This is what BCC UpRes is for. I'll clear my search results in effects and presets and type in UpRes, drag it on to my Johnny Cash photo, and within a few seconds, we should see UpRes get to work, where it's going to scale up this image 200%. That doesn't quite fit the dimensions of our new Ultra HD comp. So I'll take the scale value, I'll set this to 222, and now we can see the photo fills the composition frame. The sharpening value is a little bit too strong in this case, so I'm going to set the amount to be 5 in this instance just before export. Keep in mind that we're at half resolution, but now that this is done, I can simply go to my composition, add to render queue, and send out this Johnny Cash photo, the 4K file. Here is the end result of the Johnny Cash Ultra HD photo treatment. Excellent. Now, I also did this treatment on an additional photo, but I've already done all the steps and I just wanted to walk through some of the effects I used for finalization. So here it is. This is a public domain image. I did a similar photo fade in for the main point of attention here in the image, which is the girl and the milkshake, and use some similar effects that I did in the Johnny Cash treatment. So I added a film stocks to give this a little bit of color. We could also see BCC plus halo applied, which brightened as well as added a bit of diffuseness to each of the highlights in the image. In addition to this, I added a layer of BCC light leaks, which is animated, moving slowly over time. And I also added a few effects to the background, which one animates in and the other animates out. If we just take a look at the background layer by soloing it, you can see a texture on it. And this texture was created with S Grunge. If you haven't used S Grunge, there's a great bunch of presets combining three stamps to give you a grunge-based look. I'm going to cancel out of here. And one of my favorite values within Grunge happens to be frame softness. By animating frame softness, you can see that I slowly animated the edges of Grunge out of frame. While that texture disappeared, you'll notice that the image also gets a bit blurry. And I used S-Convolve for this to get a realistic blur rather than use the After Effects camera. So this is also available in Sapphire. You can see if I load a preset here, you can see some different examples here of these lens textures, which are very common when it comes to depending on the lens that you're using. And there you have it, bringing your stills to life using both Photoshop and After Effects and Boris Effects Continuum and Sapphire for the final touches. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you want more tutorials like this, don't forget to subscribe and check us out at borisfx.com.